हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड आफ्टरनून वन एंड ऑल। हियर आई एम गाड़ेकर सचिन पंडित। टुडे वी आर डिस्कस ऑन न्यू चैप्टर सेपरेशन ऑफ इनेंशियोमर। सो लास्ट लेक्चर वी आर डिस्कस ऑन एनालिटिकल HPLC, ओके, इन विच वी आर डिस्कस ऑन ट्रेस एनालिसिस, integration error, also we are discuss on derivatization, okay, so selection of wavelength in UV detector, so also discuss on derivatization of sample or analytes. There are two types, pre-column derivatization and post-column derivatization. These points we are discuss on last lecture. So today we are start a new chapter such as separation of enantiomer. Okay. First question: what is enantiomer? First of all, chiral molecules. Okay. So we are familiar with this chemistry. Okay. So first, enantiomer. Enantiomers are molecules that are non-superimposable mirror on their mirror images. Okay. So if the superimposable mirror image, they are not enantiomer or they are achiral molecules. Okay. So two different mirror images. Okay. So exist the chemical and physical property of enantiomers are identical. Okay. So enantiomers, that is non-superimposable mirror image of the compounds. Okay. If the superimposable mirror image, they are chirally inactive. Okay. So these enantiomers are chemical and physical properties are identical. Okay. Except plane polarized light, means R enantiomers and L enantiomers. Okay. They right rotatory plane polarized light and another is left rotatory. Okay. So these enantiomers, one is the right rotation and another is the left plane polarized light rotate. Okay. So they enantiomers cannot be separate by separation methods. Okay. Simple separation methods. So we can separate it. So these enantiomers we are separate by using chromatographic method. In presence we use a chiral phase or chiral reagent in separation for enantiomers. Okay. So different types of enantiomers we are separate only by using chromatographic technique. Okay. So chromatographic techniques we use, they so long time to complete the column completion. Okay, so that's why we use a high performance liquid chromatography, and in which if we use a chiral mobile phase or chiral stationary phase as a chiral reagent to separate a enantiomer by using chromatography. Okay, HPLC chromatography, and these enantiomers separate by chromatographically in presence of chiral phase. Okay. There are different types of chiral phase. Okay. So generally three types of chiral phases are used. Okay. You know the HPLC in presence use a stationary phase and mobile phase. Okay. In which stationary phase we use a silicate material as a fixed material. Okay. So in this, if we use a chiral reagent, there are different mobile phase as well as stationary phase to forms a chiral to separate a enantiomer. First is the mobile phase is chiral and stationary phase is non-chiral. Okay, so this is the first condition. Okay, first types, mobile phase is chiral and stationary phase is non-chiral. Okay, at that time only small amount of chiral compound is needed or chiral reagent is to be needed. Okay, so second condition, second phase is liquid stationary phase and and mobile is non-chiral. Okay, liquid stationary phase, in first stage, first step, mobile phase is chiral and stationary phase is non-chiral we are use. Second, we use a stationary phase is chiral and stationary phase, liquid stationary phase and mobile phase non-chiral. Okay, the stationary phase is coated with a solid carrier. Okay, so third is the solid stationary. Okay, second is the liquid stationary phase and third is the solid stationary phase is chiral and mobile phase is non-chiral. At that time we separate a enantiomers by using these three types of separation technique. Okay, so this method is very easy to form a stationary phase is expansive. Okay, so mobile phase is used as a chiral. Okay, so in this chiral reagent converts enantiomer to diastereomers and these diastereomers are the different coefficient. Okay, so in these all above cases diastereomers complex are formed. Enantiomer converts to diastereomers and sample molecules and asymmetric species is chromatographically system and these will migrate with different velocity through the column. Okay, first chiral molecules, chiral reagent we use to convert enantiomers to diastereomers and these diastereomers, okay, different coefficients and different velocity through the columns and then we can easily separate these enantiomers, okay, by using chiral reagent or chiral phase. There are three different types of chiral phase. Okay, first is the mobile phase is chiral and stationary phase is non-chiral. Second, liquid stationary phase is chiral and mobile phase is non-chiral. And third, stationary phase is chiral and mobile phase is non-chiral. Okay, so next slide here. Okay, this is the examples of enantiomer converts to diastereomers by using L-proline as a chiral reagent. Okay, so in this model, diastereomeric complex of D-phenylaniline and second is the means right side L-phenylaniline. Phenylaniline diastereomers form. Okay, by using L-proline as a chiral reagent. Okay, so these diastereomers we can separate easily. Okay, so these techniques are used as a separation of enantiomers by using a chiral reagent. Mobile phase as well as stationary phase. It depends on our choice and our analysis. Okay, so these methods of here represented methods is indirect separation of enantiomers. Okay, so these separation factors alpha. Separation factors is the alpha, and it is important parameters to characterize the stationary phase. Okay, so this alpha is nothing but the separation factors. Okay, enantiomer separation factor. Okay, first K2 divided by K1. K2 is the greater than K1. Okay, so is equal to R2T divided by R1T, retention time 2 to retention time T. Okay, R2T minus T0 means initial time, and then R1T minus T0. Okay, so using this equation, the separation factors we use to form enantiomer separation. Okay, alpha is equal to K divided by K1 is equal to R2T minus T0 divided by R1T minus T0. Okay, so first condition we are used for separation of enantiomer, first stage is if we use a chiral mobile phase, then the separation takes place in column. Okay, so chiral mobile phase we use, and stationary phase is non-chiral. If chiral region capable of forming a complex with the enantiomers, and these enantiomers converts a diastereomers. Okay, so chiral region able to form a complex with enantiomers, and then these enantiomers converts a diastereomers, and these diastereomers chance that the distribution coefficient increase, the distribution coefficient easy to separate. Okay, then distribution coefficient to the diastereomers to forms between the mobile and stationary phase. Okay, so these form diastereomers in mobile and stationary phase will be different, and therefore these can be easily separate on HPLC in column. Okay, so chiral mobile phase are able to forming a complex with enantiomer, and enantiomers convert diastereomers in HPLC, and these diastereomers distribution coefficient is different, and different the velocities in column. Okay, so then therefore these can be separate on the HPLC column. Okay, so this is the application of chiral mobile phase. Okay, so here example separation of enantiomer such as N1-phenylethylthalamic acid. Okay, these are the enantiomers, and these enantiomers plus and minus. Okay, so these enantiomers separate in column chromatography HPLC by using quinine as a chiral reagent. Okay, chiral iron pair reagent. Okay, these quinine as a chiral mobile phase use as formation of diastereomers of such complex, such enantiomers, such as N1-phenylethylthalamic acid. Okay, this thalamic acid converts to diastereomers form with quinine, and then these diastereomers separate. Okay, so here the example of chiral reagent we use as a quinine for separation of phenylethylthalamic acid. Okay, so this chiral iron pair reagent used for the separation of such enantiomers. Okay, so enantiomer separation with chiral mobile phase. Enantiomer separation with chiral mobile phase is the based on chemical equilibrium. Okay, enantiomer separates with chiral mobile phase is based on chemical equilibria with perhaps may fluctuate a result, maybe fluctuate a result of change in concentration. First factor, change in concentration. Second, temperature or maybe pH. Enantiomer separation with chiral mobile phase is based on chemical equilibria. It may fluctuate if change in concentration, result of change in concentration, temperature as well as pH. Okay, so result is depends on these three factors. Okay, so if the system is highly sensitive, okay, separation optimization times, if the system is highly sensitive to change in any one parameter to strictly constant once its optimum level has been found. Okay, so if the system is highly sensitive to change in any one parameter such as concentration, temperature and pH, okay, so then these must be kept strictly constant once its optimum level has been found. Okay, so some disadvantages of this chiral mobile phase. Okay, so one is the mobile phase, chiral mobile phase. One is the method is that first enantiomers exist as a diastereomers and associated after separation and whose dissociation may be impossible. Okay, first enantiomer converts a diastereomers. Okay, and these associated after separation but whose dissociation may impossible. Okay, so next is the preparative separation is impossible under these circumstances. Okay, so these is the disadvantages of chiral mobile phase. Okay, so next is the chiral liquid stationary phase. Okay, first we are discuss a chiral mobile phase. Here we discuss a chiral liquid stationary phase, second factor. Okay, so in this chiral liquid is coated, chiral liquid is coated such as silica. Silica is converted to chiral. Okay, so chiral liquid is coated on the surface of column packing particles and chiral liquid partition system is obtained. Okay, so both are the liquid. Okay, chiral liquid is coated, okay, on the surface of column packing particles and chiral liquid partition system is obtained. And the mobile phase must be saturated with stationary phase. Okay, a thermostat must be provided in order to keep it constant. Okay, so this is the examples of use in chiral liquid stationary phase, such as the dibutyl tartarate. Okay, so this is the use as a chiral reagent or chiral stationary liquid stationary phase and separate beta amino alcohols. Okay, so this chromatogram shows the separation of norpheridine enantiomers with a using reagent dibutyl tartarate as a liquid stationary phase, and this is easily separate enantiomers. Okay, so here dibutyl tartarate used as a liquid stationary phase and this used as a separate beta amino alcohols. Okay, so this is the example of chiral liquid stationary phase using in separation technique. So third is the chiral solid stationary phase. Okay, first we are discuss chiral mobile phase, second chiral liquid stationary phase. So third we are discuss a chiral solid stationary phase we use for separation of enantiomers. Okay, so enantiomer separation becomes very easy when column with solid chiral stationary phase we use. Okay, so CSP, solid chiral stationary phase. Okay, so in this different methods or different chiral stationary phase are available. Okay, the most important chiral stationary phase are the brush types. Okay, and they based on very different separation principles. Okay, so different chiral solid stationary phase are available and they different separation principles and can be shown here. First is the brush types CSP, brush types chiral stationary phase, where a small molecules, usually a pi active groups, are bonded to silicon. This is used on the basis of chiral stationary phase. First method is the first separation principle on the base brush type CSP. Second is helical polymer, mainly cellulose and its derivative, use as a separation in enantiomers. Okay, helical polymers types for separation, and in which we use a cellulose and its derivative as a stationary chiral stationary phase. And third one is the cavity phase, we use as a cyclodextrin, also use a crown ether, microcryptans and glycopeptide antibiotics. Okay, so these based on separation methods we use a cavity phase in which use a cyclodextrin, crown ethers and microcyclic glycopeptides antibiotics. Okay, fourth one is the protein phase. Okay, use a separation. And last one is the ligand exchange phase, also use. Okay, so chiral stationary phase, in which enantiomer separation becomes very easy when a column with solid chiral stationary phase we use, and this able to separate given enantiomer pair is available in our analytes. Okay, so a good deals with a literature also available in this phase. Okay, literature are also available for the separation enantiomers by using solid stationary phase, chiral solid stationary phase, and they provides commercially. Okay, they are based on different separation principles, such as just we are discuss a brush types of separation, second helical polymers, third one is the cavity phase such as cyclodextrin, crown ether, microcyclic, and protein phase also used in the separation. Okay, so these methods we use a separation. Some chiral stationary phase for brush types phases are given here. There are so many chiral stationary phase in brush types phase. We use a these types of chiral stationary phase. Okay, so here Examples of separation of enantiomers, such using as a chiral stationary phase, and such we use a dinitrobenzoyl phenyl glycine phase as a stationary phase. Okay, here these separation of racemic propanolol as a oxazolidone, okay, derivative, okay, this is a chiral enantiomers. Okay, these enantiomers we are using chiral stationary phase, such as dinitrobenzoyl phenyl glycine phase. Okay, so here we use a R or S form of propanolol compound. Okay, and they converts a diastereomers, and then these are separate. So last one is the indirect separation of enantiomers. Okay, so just we are discuss a direct separation by using chiral phase, chiral mobile phase, chiral stationary phase, chiral liquid stationary phase. In these, enantiomer converts to diastereomers, and diastereomers separate directly. Okay, by using its different velocity. Okay, different retention time in the column. Okay, so here indirect separation of enantiomers. Okay, indirect separation means it enantiomer first converts to diastereomers. Okay, and they then separate. Okay, so these methods is nothing but a indirect separation of enantiomer. Enantiomer derivatize. Firstly, enantiomers derivatize with chiral molecules to form a optically pure diastereomer. Okay, so in this indirect separation of enantiomers, enantiomers first derivatize with chiral molecules to form a optically pure diastereomers, and it consists more than one center of asymmetry. Okay, if the molecules consist symmetry, they are chirally inactive. Okay, so that's why molecule contains a center of asymmetry. Okay, therefore differ in their physical property, otherwise they can't be separate. Okay, so these methods, indirect separation methods, diastereomers converts optically pure diastereomers, and they differ in their physical property, and then they are the separate. Means enantiomers converts diastereomers and separate with non-chromatographic system. Okay, so enantiomer converts diastereomers and they separate. Okay, and these methods is nothing but a indirect separation of enantiomers, means conversion of diastereomers and then separate by using HPLC. Separation of reagent is more important. Okay, in this we are add a chiral reagent, and this separation of reagent is more important as well as optically pure. Okay, otherwise isomers will be formed, means enantiomeric isomers forms a diastereomer. Okay, and these isomers cannot be separate in chiral systems, and result will be reverse. Okay, that's why selection of reagent is more important. Okay, selection of reagent is more important as well as optically purity. Okay, so otherwise isomers will be formed, and these isomers cannot separate in chiral system, and result will be reverse. Okay, So also prevent the racemization. Also prevents the racemization during derivatization. Okay. So indirect separation methods, we use a conversion of diastereomers, means derivatization, and these times prevent the racemization during the this derivatization. Okay. If excess reagent also prevent excess reagent utilization in this. Okay. The table shows purity of the reagent and obtained purity of the sample. Okay. This is the purity of reagent is 99.95 and then obtained purity of sample is 99.90. Okay. So high purity may be formed in sample. So second is the so similarly other examples. So here a represent a separation of enantiomers such as R and S metaprolol. Okay, R and S form metaprolol. These converts to diastereomers by using derivatization. First is the chloroformate. These chiral reagent used to convert a diastereomers and forms its derivative. And such derivatives is SS forms of derivative. Okay. So RS metaprolol is converts to its diastereomers by using a chiral reagent such as chloroformate. Okay. And these can be separated by HPLC. Okay. So here graph shows the reaction of RS metoprolol enantiomers. Okay. This is the enantiomers. RS means one form the R and second is the S forms enantiomers with chiral reagent and determine ratio of enantiomers. Okay. So this graph shows the separation of metaprolol enantiomers by using a chiral reagent. And this functional group converts to derivatize. Okay. This indirect separation method, functional group converts to derivatize like amide, carbamates or urea. Okay. All these classes compounds have a relatively rigid structures with a facilitate the separation. Okay. So these methods we can apply for the separation of enantiomers by indirect separation methods. Okay, enantiomer separation methods. Okay, but in remember that diastereomers may have differing detector properties determine the calibration curve. Okay, so these points will be remember. Diastereomers may have differ detector property and determine the calibration curve. And these properties compare with our starting enantiomeric property. Okay. So these points will be remembered. And these types of separation favorable with the sample of biological origin. Okay, at that time these indirect separation methods we are used for biological origin sample separation. Okay. So thank you watching this video. Thank you one and all.